Number 1. Sala de Uyuni. For a truly out-of-this-world travel destination, it's hard to match the Sala de Uyuni. One of the flattest places in the world, the 4,000-square-mile salt flats were formed by a prehistoric lake. Visitors travel in 4x4 vehicles across the expanse of the salt flats to visit locally fashioned structures made entirely from bricks of salt. The salt flats are at their most spectacular after a rain, when water sitting atop the cemented salt acts like a mirror, perfectly reflecting the sky above. Number 2. Tiwanaku. Located near the southeastern shore of Lake Titicaca in Bolivia, Tiwanaku is one of the most important precursors to the Inca Empire. The community grew to urban proportions between the 7th and 9th centuries, becoming an important regional power in the southern Andes. At its peak, the city had between 15,000 to 30,000 inhabitants. While only a small part has been excavated, Tiwanaku represents the greatest megalithic architectural achievement of pre-Inca South America. Number 3. Lake Titicaca. Bordering Bolivia and Peru, Lake Titicaca is the largest lake in South America. Incans, as well as a number of other native peoples, are thought to have originated in the region. Near the southeastern shore of the lake lies Tiwanaku, ruins of an ancient city-state that scholars believe was a precursor of the Inca Empire. Lake Titicaca is a popular vacation destination. The original Copacabana is a favorite resort for both tourists and locals. Number 4. Madidi National Park. Madidi National Park stretches from the Andes to the Amazon. Encompassing over 7,000 square miles, Madidi is known as one of the most biologically diverse parks in the world. Visitors to Madidi may spot an elusive jaguar, a giant otter, or the titi monkey, a species of monkey found nowhere else in the world. More than 11% of the planet's 9,000 species of birds can be found in Madidi National Park. Number 5. Sucre. Known as the City of Four Names, Sucre is also called Charcas, La Plata, and Chuquisaca. Founded in the 1500s by Spanish colonials, Sucre offers visitors a clear glimpse of life in aristocratic Spain in the 16th century. Sucre has many important historical buildings worth visiting, including La Casa de la Libertad, where Simon Bolivar wrote the Bolivian Constitution, and Bolivia's National Library, which features documents dating to the 15th century.